Hi everyone, welcome and thanks to watching this video. And if you like, don't forget to subscribe my channel. So this is a simulink model which you see, that is a spring mass temper equation which I have designed here. That is a second order differential equation. So what we are going to do, here you see that we have a damping coefficient. We'll run this model on my Intel processor, I mean on the top of this machine, and from the Simulink environment, while this model will be running, we can tune this parameter as well. So I think you got the overall agenda what we are going to do. First thing, we are going to run this model within the Simulink environment. We'll get some output, right? And in the next step, we are going to run this model on my Intel processor. Means not within the Simulink environment, but on my processor we are going to run. Okay, here I have this tab which you see, this is connected to this. While this model is running, I can check that whatever output I want, I am getting here or not. So I am not going to discuss how to design this model. If you want to know how to design model in Simulink, you can watch my previous videos. And here I have this display block, so on the top of this model I can watch, I can see the output as well here. Okay, so first thing which we have to do, we have to simulate this model within the Simulink environment first of all, and whatever output will be here we can log that. Then in the second step, same model we are going to run on Windows, I mean on Intel processor, and whatever the output will come from there, we are going to match that. When we are happy with that, then my model is fine, then further we can do some other testing as well. Okay, so first step here, what we have to do, first of all we require a C compiler. So to check that if you have any third party C compiler or not, just simply give this command, and here you will be able to see that if you have C compiler or not. If you don't have any C compiler, here you will get a error and a link also from where you can download. So right now the free version MinGW compiler is there. You can install this MinGW compiler, and to do that, just simply here you have to click Git add-ons, and from here you can install that MinGW. So and further you can check you have it. Why we require, because we are going to generate the C code, we are going to generate a .exe file, so it will be compiled, then further we are going to run on Windows machine outside the Simulink mode, Simulink environment. Fine. So first step is this, and so once we have designed this model, we have to do some configurations. So let's see what configurations we have to do here. Simply you have to go in modeling and you have to click here in the setting. Here you can select, are you going to generate the C or C++ codes. In my case, I am going to generate the C++ code in the code generation. First thing. Second, here you see you have to take this, be sure that this states, time and output and data stores are ticked or not, because when we run the model we require this data to compare that, right? Next step, when you go in the interface, because I have to interface this Simulink model with the Intel processor, right? In that case we are going to run this model external mode, so we have to take this. And further, we can choose either TCP/IP or XCP on TCP/IP. XCP, if you have serial, you can choose serial, because I am going to create a communication using TCP/IP protocol. So XCP on TCP/IP. So what is XCP? When I select this XCP here, this will work in the real time. And when it, I mean, when I run this model, I will be able to communicate with this damping gain block and with this damping factor. Second thing here, once we have done this, remember this configurations are like this, which I have done here, right? This only these things we have to do here. Okay, next step here, what we are going to do, just simply you see, if I go in the simulation, when I click here run, so it will run within the Simulink environment. And if I go in the hardware, you see that we have one more tab, build, deploy and start. So if I click build only, then it will create a C file only. And if I click build, deploy and start, I require to connect the hardware. Okay, So it will be deployed on hardware and it will be executed there as well. So if you want to execute on some hardware, that also possible. So if you, again, if I go in hardware setting here, you can see that you can choose on which hardware are you going to deploy. So right now, device vendor Intel, as I told, and I have a Windows 64. So I choose this one because I am going to run on this window. Okay. Once you have installed that third-party C compiler, you can install Microsoft Visual also. Depends on you. What kind of compiler do you want? If you don't have, you will get a link by giving this command, and from there you can find out. Okay, monitor and tune, this we are going to use to deploy this model on this window machine. Okay, so first thing what I am going to do, simply I am going to run this and I will log my data here in the data inspector also. Just simply I am going to run, and you see here the force is input, the output we are getting that displacement. This is the first integrator, second integrator, and here you see we are getting this output, right? Now you see while it is running, I can change the damping in. And I can check that this output which I want I am getting or not, or it is following this force or not. So depends on you that what kind of output do you want, you can check while your model is running. So it's running very perfect, means as I wanted. You see that the red one is, that is output from this model, and the blue one which you see that is force. And if I go in the data inspector, here also I can check the output. So just simply I am logging this data in my data inspector. So here if I go and if I see here, this is my X data here and this is force which we see here, right? Fine. So if you want to log this data in the data inspector, just simply select this. Okay, go in the signal from here. As I am going, there is an option log signal data. It will start logging there as well. Okay, so this is the model which I want. So this is called the model in the loop. I simulated my model within the Simulink, and this is a model in the loop. I am happy with the output, whatever input I am giving to my model. So I am happy with that. Now next step is we are going to generate compiled C and C code for that, and .exe file also. And once C file and .exe file compiled file is generated, I am going to run on my window machine. Then I am going to connect that, and I want to check from that .exe file as well. So for that, what I am going to do, simply I will go in the hardware. This option only you will get when you select the XCP on TCP/IP. Okay, so from here, first thing we have to click here, and there is option build for monitoring. So once I will click this, it will create a C file for me. So it will take a little time when you run a first time. So first of all, we are creating a C file, then we are going to run that C file on Intel. So now you see that C file is generated here for the complete model, and here you can see this is a report, and you can see that what kind of codes are generated here, right? So if I go here, this is a data file, this is a C file for that. So you see that complete C code is generated. We didn't have to write a single code for that, right? So here we have C code. Now code is generated, and let me close this. It is still busy. Okay, if I go here, and if you see that for the same model, I have a .exe file as well here, right? Now we have to deploy this model. So where we are going to deploy? On this Intel processor. So once I will click this, this model will be deployed on the Intel. Once I will click on this, I will have option to connect. So when I click this connect, means this model will be connected with the .exe file which is running on my Intel hardware, right? So here we have option to connect this also. And what I want to do, simply point for 0.2 second we are going to run here. Just simply I'm going to connect this. So right now my model is running on window. So if I go in the task manager, I can check from there also. And the last option is we are going to start. Right now this complete model will run on my window machine, not within the Simulink environment. And from here we can tune the parameters also. Just For the tuning purpose, you can just stop time, you can provide infinity, INF, and while it is running, you can tune that. Okay, this output which I have got here, the X value, that is from my window machine. So I am going in data inspector and I am going to compare that. So previously we have already run on the Simulink. So here we have in archive, right? So this is the last one which I have. Just 1 minute. Let me check here. Okay. Here if I go, just simply I'm going to take this x-axis and I'm going to untake this. So this run, the previous one in the archive, this was on the Simulink environment, and this x which you see, that was simulated on this machine hardware, right? So you can see there is some differences also. Why this is important? Because whatever analysis we are doing in the Simulink, we have to test it also, that is it working on other machine or not. That is very important. So in my next video, if you see, I will show you the processor in the loop, means how we can run the controller in hardware, and through that controller how we can control the virtual plant in the Simulink also. That is a processor in the loop, and this is the real time workshop, it is called. Not only on the same host machine, you can run on a different machine also. I want to compare this also, that how much error I am getting. Just simply here you see, I clicked here as a compare, and compare to so I have to select the run. So third and fourth run I am talking about. So third run is here and fourth run is here. Okay, so just simply I have to click here compare. So I have just clicked here compare. I want to compare this X. I am going to just select. You can see here two, we have run 4 and run 3. The blue one which you see, that was simulated on my machine, and the red one which you see, it was simulated within the Simulink environment. And here you can see we have our differences also. You can see that there is difference. But let's say if I am not happy with that this error, then I can modify my model further, and again I will run that and I will check that if it is working fine, then it's good to go, right? So this is the way. If you have any questions, if you have doubt, you can ask me. So any kind of model you can design here, and you can test on the host machine. That is a real-time workshop. Okay, here you see this is a damping and this is a dashboard. From where you will get that, just simply when you go in the library, and from the library you can get this from dashboard, and you see that here some libraries are open. So I am using this dashboard scope, and here we have knob also, right? So you can connect this by simply just click on this here, and whatever you want to connect, just select this, and here just connect it. That's it. Okay, now the next step which is very important. Okay, I have done everything, I have generated the code as well, and my code is saved here in this folder. Okay, but next step, what I want to do, I want to create a report also. That is automatic report. I want to create a report as well. So further, let's say I want to show someone, or let's say I want for the certification purpose or for the patent purpose, I don't have to write anything manually. Simply I will go here in the app. So here is the app tab, and from this app tab simply I will click search here report, and you see that I have this report generator, right? So for this model, I am going to generate the report. Okay, so it's still opening. As I told, this is a real-time workshop. So what I am going to do, simply I am going to select this. Sorry, this one in this folder I have. So you see that you can generate automatic report for Simulink models also here. So I am going to generate a report for the real-time workshop which I have done. So simply I will, here there is an option here also, associate report with a current Simulink model also, right? And so simply here if I see, just simply associate with the current model also is the option. Okay, next step is that just select this from here, and generate report, there is an option, and we can generate the report also for that as well. So it will, the complete report will be generated for that. Okay, here you see, this is the my report generator. It is one by step, it is generating the report for that. We don't have to write manually anything for that, and we'll get a complete report for this model. So it is still generating, and you see that we have the complete report of that model. Not only the code which we have generated here, we have parameter values also. Here you can see that we have parameters value also here available here. That's perfect. So we can use these reports, and further if you want to do some kind of modifications, like you don't want as a PDF file, as a WAV file, PDF file. So from this side, once you will add this report here, once you generate, or manually if you want to do, depends on you that if you want to do manually also. So from the left right side, you can modify also as a doc file, as a PDF file also, depends on you. So this was the session for that. If you have any query, again you can write in a comment, and the report which I have generated already, it is saved here in this file. You see that complete HTML file I have for that. So that's all for today in this session. Next I will show you processor in the loop. Okay, bye, take care.